Are we live? D R E A M E R R T V. Good evening, divine dreamers. Bless you for taking time out of your frenetic, buzzingly vibrant reverie regime to get on our wavelength for tonight's twinkle, tingle, twilight tea party. And by Andromeda, Delphinus and Fixus, do we have some first-class bavardage for you? Serendipity must be your sleepy time programming scout, since you managed to find us on this super secret underground frequency. We're blissed out that you found us here in the underground. So blissed out. So blissed out. But let's keep this a secret. We wouldn't want any of the uninitiated dreamers finding out about our little coffee clash dream cobble now, would we? No. So we can keep this as our own little private cool kid club. Please, whatever you do, don't tell anyone else about this frequency. That means do not like, comment, or subscribe, so we here at Dreamer TV can remain incognito, cloak and dagger, and obscure for as long as possible. Hopefully for eternity. But in the total mishap of an event that we do get discovered and exposed, you can say you rode this wavelength before it was mainstream. Yalla, yalla, it's time, it is time, time to settle in. Real nice and comfy cozy with a cup of your favorite dream drops, your most potent onerogens, for a tete-a-tete, a heart-to-heart, a chin wag, and a little tittle-tattle with YouTube's number 42 psychic and prognosticator, Sylvia Braun. Where else to start tonight's Twilight Tea Party than in the dreamscape of ASMR? Exactly. So let's kick off with the most noshable news, shall we? Lean in close, because this is some highly sensitive, off the record tea I'm about to spill. Closer. A little closer. Even closer. All right, now let me get in your ear with this one. Do I have your consent to whisper straight into your ear? Perfect, 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 and fantabulous. We have been blessed enough to get our psychic minds and our hands and ears and eyes on some top secret documents. Mm-hmm. We have it. A classified dossier from an emergency summit convened by the Intergalactic Medical Association and attended by representatives from every branch and vine of physical and mental health communities. Did you get that? Perfect. All right. Let me just check something. The documents in this dossier reveal that everything is going according to plan. The medical communities' butts are burned about the impact the proliferation and success of ASMR has had on their pocketbooks. And their pride. You know what I mean? Of course you do. Alright. Well, for example, Exhibit A, Exhibit A, Exhibit A. Take a look at these statistics. Right. Take a look at these statistics right here. Mm-hmm. Cold, hard numbers. It's all bad news for doctors and noshy news for ASMRtists. Last month alone, 750,000 doctors had to file for partial or full unemployment. 750,000 in a single month. Astonishing. Most of those reported job losses were among cranial nerve specialists, optometrists, and general practitioners who perform annual checkups. Those numbers don't even include school nurses who specialize in lice checks, Reiki practitioners, paramedics, and phlebotomists. Oh no, oh no. There are over 20 pages devoted to the detrimental impact that ASMR has had on professional practices of waking world psychotherapists, life coaches, and massage therapists. All right here. Mm-hmm. But wait, as peed off as the medical community is, oh, this is rich. There is concession after concession, evidential stats, essentially proving that ASMR is working. Take a look at this. Over 1 million dreamers detected cranial nerve malfunctions last month alone and were able to get treatment before these became too life-threatening. Mm-hmm. And an additional additional 2 million hypochondriacs were able to rule out cranial nerve damage as the cause of their phantom pains in just the past week. Not bad, not bad, dreamers. Mm-hmm. Brava, bravo. And then, there's this excerpt from the report. Mm-hmm. There's this excerpt from the report. With few exceptions, the mind-boggling proliferation of ASMR medical roleplays and the spike in participation in these simulated roleplays of medical procedures has impacted the medical sector, the health and wellness industry in immeasurable ways. Medical professionals speculate that the dramatically diminished number of patients seeking consultations for annual health checkups, cranial nerve exams, eye exams, and lymphatic massage is largely, if not entirely, due to the unprecedented numbers of patients taking responsibility for their own health. The general population, the majority of which now seem to be ASMR partakers, perform almost nightly self-checks on every and all aspects of their physical and mental health. If this trend continues, it does not bode well for the future of the established health and wellness communities. And then there's this little footnote I felt compelled to share. An odd finding of our research has been that pediculosis, lice have virtually been eliminated or sequestered from the human population due to diligent, almost obsessively frequent checks and treatments performed by ASMR. Lice check medical professionals. This dossier is quite amusing, is it not? More risible than the onion on a good day. Mm-hmm. More? You want to hear more? Well, you got it. You got it. Okay? Well, there's a whole section devoted to stats on how many doctors and therapists have abandoned their brick-and-mortar practices to set up shop on YouTube. Ah, spectacular. Unbelievable. Mm-hmm. And there's just pages and pages and pages of complaints about supply shortages and scarcity of rubber gloves, stethoscopes, spigmometer cups, current thermometers, glucometers, lancets, alcohol wipes, reflex hammers, peak flow meters, specimen bottles, and swabs, just to name a few. As well as a as well as complaining about the rising costs of white jackets due to the vast number of medical roleplay ASMRtists entering the field. On a similar note, there may be a shortage of medical supplies in the medical world, but there certainly is no paucity of protestations that there aren't any licensure or barriers to entry into the profession of ASMR medical role player. An astronomical amount of number crunching and economic forecasting related to the low barriers to entry to the field, and the result of that, predictions that it will create a race to the bottom since there are too many players in the game, and which will inevitably lead to low profit margins. That said, the outcome of the summit should come as no surprise. You ready for this? Make sure you're relaxed and comfy. This could sting a bit. Well, maybe get a little shock. Okay. The health and wellness community, the professional medical community, has informally declared a trade war on ASMR. That's right. There's a whole list of action items, subterfuge strategies, here are some key planned actions that you need to be aware of. 1. Create barriers to entry through medical licensure requirements. 2. Require proof of licensure for the purchase of any and all medical supplies. 3. Ban the sale of medical uniforms as costumes and restrict their sale to authorized vendors only. And 4. Get this one. Pursue malpractice and fraud suits against any person known to be impersonating a medical professional. Outrageous, right? Outrageous. What will they come up with next? No, but seriously. Seriously. We're not going to take this standing up. No. Are we dreamers? Of course not. Of course not. We must lie down and enhance our dream defense systems. You with me? Perfect. Okay. Now listen up. Listen up. Listen up. Listen. We have to be soldered in solidarity together if we are going to resist this onslaught by the medical cart. Right? Right. So, we here at Dreamer TV have devised a plan. Listen carefully. It's rather complex, so you may need to take notes. You need to get something to write with. Okay. Many contingencies. Right. Let me know when you're ready. All set? Groovy. First, what we need to do is we need to create our own professional, we need to create